Friends, welcome to Input Output Canvas. So today in this video we'll discuss about a coding question for placement, and the question is replace all question marks to avoid consecutive repeating characters. Okay, so first read the question here. Given a string is containing only lowercase English letters and the question mark character, so you have to convert all the question marks into lowercase letters such that the final string does not contain any consecutive repeating characters. So here you can see an input string is given and the question mark is present. And if you see in the input string, there is no consecutive repeating characters. Okay, so in the place of this question mark, you have to write some characters so that the final string does not contain any consecutive repeating characters. So you cannot modify the non-question mark character. It is guaranteed that there are no consecutive repeating characters in the given string except for question mark. Return the final string after all the conversions, possibly zero, have been made. If there is more than one solution, return any of them. So you can return any of the solution, but it should follow the condition. Okay, that is, there should not be any consecutive repeating characters in the final string. So it can be shown that the answer is always possible with the given constraint. And the constraint is the length of S is between 1 to 100 and S contains only lowercase English letters and question mark. Okay, so hope you understand the question. Now we will write the code using C++. So first of all, write the basic format of the C++, that is S include bit/standard C++.h, and using namespace standard, and then write the main function. Okay, so inside this main function we'll write a string, that is input string, so string s. Okay, and we'll copy the input string from here. Okay, let's copy it from here and paste it here. Give it a semicolon. Now write a function where we'll do all the operations. So the name of the function is avoid. Okay, and pass the string from here. Okay, now we for this main function write the same function, that is the avoid function, and the return type will be string because it will return a string. So write here string avoid. And inside this, write your string s. So first we need the size of the string. So first calculate the size of the string. So int n equals to s dot size. So this will calculate the size of the string. Now we'll write a for loop to iterate the string s. Okay. So for int I equals to 0. I less than n and I plus plus. So inside this for loop we'll check if the character, that is the ith character, is question mark or not. If the character is question mark, then we'll write a for loop. Okay, character j equals to a and j less than equals to z and j plus plus. Inside this for loop we'll check if I minus 1 is greater equals to 0 and S of I minus 1 is equals to Z. So see here, friends. So for the first I value, that is I equals to 0, we'll check if S of I equals to the question mark. Yes, S of I equals to question mark. So we'll go to this for loop, and for J equals to A, we'll check if I minus 1 greater equals to 0. So I is 0, so 0 minus 1, that is minus 1, minus 1 is greater or equals to 0. Now this condition false, and S of I minus 1, so I is 0, so S of minus 1 is equals to J. S of minus 1 means the minus 1 position of S is equals to J, J means A. So this is also false. So if this condition satisfied, so if this if condition satisfied, then we'll continue. Continue means we'll skip this step. Okay, we'll check another if condition. if I plus 1 less than n and s of I plus 1 equals to j, and if this condition satisfied, again we will skip this step, and finally we will store j into s of I. So j will be stored into s of I, and we will break this for loop. That is, we will go outside of this for loop, and after going outside the outer for loop, we will return the s. So just return s from here. So we will store the return value here. So write here string answer, and we'll print the output. So to print the output, write a for loop for int I equals to 0, I less than answer dot size I plus plus, and see out here answer of I. Okay, so let's run this, and you can see the output is not as expected. So where's the problem? So you can see here in the if condition we have give only one equal sign, so here will be two equal sign. Okay, so let's run it again, and you can see our output is perfect because there is no consecutive repeating characters. So our expected output was A C Y W A I P K J A, and here also you can see A B Y W A I P K J Y A. Okay, so you can check this program by giving another test cases. Okay, so this is it for now, and hope you enjoyed this video, and if you find this video helpful, then please like the video and share it with your friends. So thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video. Till then, take care.